Hi, I'm DeDe Cordell, your anchor for Go Meet Do in District 5180, our video newsletter, where we bring you news from around the district, what's happened, and what's happening. Welcome to January 2024. Oh my goodness, Happy New Year. I hope you've all had a fantastic holiday season. How many of you are still writing 2023 as the date? Be honest. Getting that right is almost as hard as sticking to your New Year's resolutions. Am I right? Let's start this new year off with a message from our district governor, Sydney Smith.
Hey, fellow Rotarians, it's a blustery January morning. Happy New Year. Hey, I wanted to tell you that the best part about this month is that it's Vocational Services Month, and we get to do great things. Like, some of you know that I'm a rancher. That's right. Here are my sheep, and the cool thing about these sheep is they just stand here. They don't do anything, and they just look good. So hope you have a great Vocational Services Month. Happy New Year. We'll turn it over to you, DeDe. You sheep, be still.
Thanks, Sydney. I guess that's one way to make sure your animals behave. We recently asked each club president to send us pictures and videos of what they worked on during the fall of 2023, and y'all have been busy. Here is what we received. The Rotary Clubs of Carmichael and Rancho Cordova teamed up for a citrus orchard project at the Soilborne Farms in Rancho Cordova. Rancho Cordova President Mike Passoff and Carmichael co-president George Abraham were joined by Rotarians Neil Orchard, Carrie Johnson, and others to work with the founder and co-director of Soilborne Farms, Sean Harrison, and the greenhouse manager, Emily Hain, in executing this project. The Rotary Club of Walnut Grove held a pumpkin weight guess contest as part of a project that saw deserving students receiving pumpkins for Halloween, courtesy of the club. Also, as a way to celebrate their year, the club held a Christmas lunch at a brand new local restaurant called the Steamboat Bar and Grill, where members shared family-style Chinese food and exchanged white elephant gifts. Restaurant owner and club supporter Andy Chan was on hand to join in the festivities. Just about every community I visit, I see a sign that displays the logos of active service clubs in that community. Of course, it always fills me with great pride when I see the Rotary Wheel, but many times these signs are a little bit distressed, right? Longtime Roseville Rotarian Ralph Felix noticed that about the Roseville sign as well and decided to do something about it. In a service project that has spanned multiple years, the Rotary Club of Roseville decided to take maintenance ownership of the sign and completely replaced the old sign with a robust new one featuring the city logo and the logos of the 13 active service organizations in the community. This December marked the completion of the project. Congrats, some really amazing work there. The Rotary Club of South Sacramento had a guest speaker in November that was so impactful, a service project was born immediately in response. The speaker was Christy Kiefer, program manager for the organization Community Against Sexual Harm, or CASH. Their mission is to provide a safe haven for sexually exploited women. The club's project was to put together a large donation of women's clothing, gift certificates, and diapers for CASH, which they delivered on December 15th. The club also wanted to announce that their 12th annual crab feed and silent auction will be coming up on February 3rd at the Scottish Rite Temple in Sacramento, with entertainment provided by the YOLO High School Jazz Ensemble. Only 500 tickets are available, so go to southsacrotary.org and get your tickets today. In December, the Rotary Club at Folsom Lake held a thank you recognition for longtime club member Alan Moore, who's moving to Oklahoma to be closer to his daughter. Alan served in multiple positions, including the foundation board and as club president in 2021-22. He will be missed. The Rotary Club of Gridley wanted to shout out the foundation dinner committee for a great event back in November. Pictured here are President Clark Redfield, President-elect Lynn Spencer, past President Ravi Ajla, and member Catalina Sanchez. Meanwhile, the Rotary Club of South Yuba County Sunrise rang the bell for the Salvation Army at the Linda Walmart on December 9th, and they got their Lyndhurst High School Interact Club to participate with them. The club also welcomed its newest member, Doris Luther, of Plumas Lake, into the club. Welcome, Doris. The 14-member strong Rotary Club of Foothill Highlands, 14 members, had quite a busy December. The month started out with a holiday party that included a white elephant gift exchange and recognition of members Teresa Ferrer and Patrick Magnani for achieving new Paul Harris Fellow levels. Congrats. The club executed the distribution of over 140 dictionaries to three local schools. Past President Dominic Mecklenburg had the kids pledge to learn one new word every day. The club also hosted and volunteered as cooks and servers at a breakfast with Santa at the KF Dayhill Community Center. Proceeds from the breakfast go towards the scholarship fund of the North Highlands Recreation and Park District. Finally, the club participated in the North Highlands Recreation and Park District Community Holiday Parade. Club members joined local fire and police officers and community agencies to tour two different neighborhoods, handing out goodies and treats to residents and their families along the parade route. How fun is that? Those are some seriously busy Rotarians. That club is small but mighty. And while we are on the subject of holiday celebrations, these clubs submitted their photos and videos from their holiday parties. The Rotary Club of Folsom's holiday party was themed the Rotary Margaritaville Holiday Party in honor of the newest Margaritaville resort in South Lake Tahoe. A $500 gift card to the resort was awarded at the end of the night. It's pretty cool. That ended in a conga line, of course. Not to be outdone, the Rotary Club of Point West did their rendition of the 12 Days of Christmas. Take a look.
On the 12th day of Christmas,
my true love gave to me 12 kunas mumbling.
Jerry's chucking.
Nine reindeer dancing.
Eight traumatic brain injuries.
As Rotarians, we are all part of Rotary International. One of the ways we stay connected internationally is through the Rotary Youth Exchange Program, or RYE. On December 2nd, two of our district's inbound RYE students, Javier from Spain and Luana from Brazil, had quite an adventure. They shopped and had dinner in Old Sacramento, where they met up with former RYE students, Lena from Germany and Bella from Bolivia. The group got to attend a Sacramento Kings game that night. The next day, they were the guests of honor at a holiday party breakfast at the home of the Brandenburg family, where Executive Secretary to the District Governor, Maria Mangotti, delivered gifts and a message from the District Governor, Sydney Smith. Finally, as a reminder, we want all of your stories, so get them to us. Here's how you do it. You can report your own video story by recording yourself at the event and then email that video to gomeetdoin d5180@gmail.com. If the file's too large to email it, just send us an email, tell us about it, we'll send you a link to give you a place where you can upload it. You can also just send us information about your events with graphics and or photos and we'll do the reporting for you, but it's so much better when we get to see your beautiful faces and you don't have to listen to me blather on for the entire newscast like you did this time. Whatever you do, please make sure that all of your videos and photos are high resolution and shot horizontally. That's it for this episode. Stick with those resolutions. Good luck. And we'll see you in February. I'm DeDe Cordell. Now get out there and go meet Dude.